And welcome back to The Bridge. So May is Mental Health Awareness Month, and we are going to check in with Trillium Family Services, and Kim Scott is joining us with their Keep Oregon Well campaign. Kim, welcome to the show. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing fine, and thank you for having me. I really appreciate it, Justin.
I appreciate you coming on the show. We got a lot of stuff to get to, but let's start with the basics of Trillium Family Services. Who are you guys, and how long have you been here in Oregon?
Yeah, so Trillium is an organization that came together through a merger in 1998, but the three organizations that merged were Perry Center for Children has been in Oregon since 1867, Waverly Children's Home since 1991, and the Children's Farm Home, or 1891, and Children's Farm Home in Corvallis since 1921.
Wow. So you guys have been here, obviously, a very, very long time. But let's talk about the Keep Oregon Well campaign. How did that start and what is it all about?
Yeah, a number of years ago, we really invested into the trauma-informed understanding and trauma-informed care and really embraced that. And a few years ago, we were doing a community meeting with various providers and advocates in the mental health world. And I made the comment that this is about a cultural shift. If we can think about health and wellness and include mental health, it would be a shift that you know, if we can create a culture in Portland around keeping Portland weird, I thought we can create a culture around keeping Oregon well. And it stuck. And so we've built on that.
I know a lot has been talked about, especially as we are all in our homes now, you know, doing this interview from your home and from my kitchen, but about mental health. But when you look at overall health, how important is it? And what are maybe some of the things that people maybe miss or forget about when talking about the aspects of mental health?
Yeah, well, you know, for years, I think that we as a people have focused on mental health as this problem that's separate from the overall, you know, our overall functioning. We've kind of separated the mind from the body. And I think that one of our goals at Trillium, and I think across the whole sector of mental health, is putting the mind and the body back together again and understanding that mental health has such a core focus of our everyday health and wellness. At Trillium, our vision is to change the national narrative around health and wellness to include mental health and the social determinants that impact health.
So let's talk about the Keep Oregon Well Awards. How did the awards start, and what's all the info on the Keep Oregon Well Awards?
Yeah, so, you know, for years, we've been focusing on lifting up heroes who are trying to make a difference in their community. You know, this year we have folks that have worked within Trillium's programs. We have strong leaders out in the community who are mental health advocates, all really working at reducing stigma. And, you know, when I look at that kind of work, from our perspective, heroism is about that connection, kind of going beyond oneself to support others in profound ways. And we're really excited about our heroes this year.
All right. Kim Scott of Trillium Family Services. Keep Oregon Well is the campaign. May is Mental Health Awareness Month, but also, you know, keep in mind in mental health awareness at all times. Kim, thank you so much for the time. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Justin, for having me. Really appreciate it as well. Good day.
All right. And one of the recipients of one of the Keep Oregon Well Hero Awards was Keenan Lowe of Park Rose High School. We caught up with him a couple of months ago when he was made an appearance at a Blazer game. Here's Keenan Lowe from Park Rose High School.
In that struggle, did you guys exchange any words? Was anything said between you and that student?
Well, once I got the gun and I kind of called for another teacher to come to grab the gun from me. Then it was just me and that student. And, you know, it was a real emotional time. It was emotional for him. It was emotional for me. You know, in that time, I felt compassion for him. You know, and a lot of times, especially when you're young, you don't realize what you're doing until it's over, right? And, you know, kids today, there's a lot of challenges growing up in this day and age that they go through, and that, you know, with the mental health thing and access to weapons and all this stuff, you know, it's all a big problem that we need a solution for, and there's no quick fixes in it. But I felt compassion for the kid, to be honest. You know, I had a real life conversation. He broke down, and I just wanted to let him know that I was there for him. I told him I was there to save him. I was there for a reason, and that, you know, this is a life worth living.
Everyone's using the word hero, and rightfully so. I mean, from our perspective, how do you respond to it?
I respond to that just, you know, I think the universe works in amazing ways. I think I've gone through stuff in my life that has prepared me for that moment. And, you know, I'm lucky, and I'm happy that I was in that classroom for those kids, and that I was able to prevent that tragedy. I don't know necessarily hero is the right word, but, you know, the universe works in mysterious ways. And I was, you know, I was meant to be in that classroom, and I was meant to stop a tragedy.
What's your message to other staff leaders around the country that deal with this, unfortunately, often? To step in and you don't want to call yourself a hero, but you were.
Yeah, and I think, you know, my message to staff members or people that work in schools is love your kids. You know, I wouldn't have signed up to coach Park Rose football or signed up to be a security guard at Park Rose if I didn't love these kids. You know, if you're a teacher, if you're a staff member, you should love your kids. And I would expect every teacher and every staff member to do what they can in you know, to make sure stuff like this doesn't happen. Again, it was kind of, the universe works in crazy ways. So, you know, I just happened to be in that same classroom. Obviously, that student didn't know I was right there when he was going to open the door. I was in within, you know, arm's length of him. So obviously it happened fast, and I was able to get to him. You know, so I'm lucky in that way. But, you know, to staff members, school teachers, all that, just love your kids. We have to protect that next generation. And I look at myself as someone that wants to protect that next generation and wants to continue to spread love around this world, and especially around Portland.